This is part two of the material and energy balance's final review. In this screencast, we'll be going through the energy balance portion of the problem. In the previous part one, we went through a combustion problem and we completed the material balances. And now we're going to calculate how much energy that reaction produces in our reactor. So we have ethane and air coming into a combustion chamber. The ethane is at 25 degrees Celsius and the air is heated to 100 degrees Celsius prior to entering the reactor. Now the products leave the chamber at 300 degrees Celsius. Now this includes carbon monoxide since we were told in the original problem that the combustion was incomplete. So to determine the energy that comes out of this reactor from this reaction, we're going to use the heat of formation method. So in doing this, since we have multiple species and at different conditions, the best way to start any energy balance is to set up a table. Now in this table, we'll have a column that represents our species, and each row will be a different species in our material balance. So then we keep track of the flow rate and specific enthalpy associated with that species in that stream. So for a single inlet and single outlet, we should get four columns where we represent our moles that are coming in and our moles that are coming out of our reactor. Now this was already calculated in part one, so see that to determine those values. So we want to figure out the specific enthalpy of each species at the conditions stated. We know that for moles in, we have ethane at 25 degrees Celsius, but we have oxygen at 100 degrees Celsius and nitrogen at 100 degrees Celsius. Now for our outlet, we're at 300 degrees Celsius. So this is where the table is going to come in handy in terms of keeping track of each enthalpy associated with each species. So how are we going to do this? The first step once we have our table is to choose appropriate references so that we can look up or calculate the specific enthalpies of each species. Now since we're using the heat of formation method, I'm going to say that our references are going to be the standard elements. So carbon, solid, oxygen gas, hydrogen gas, and nitrogen gas at 25 degrees Celsius in one atmosphere. Now you'll see why I do this in a minute, but basically since we're using the heat of formation method, we want the reference state to be the individual elements at 25 degrees Celsius, mainly because that's a nice reference temperature to use and it's easy to look up those values in multiple different places. So to determine the specific enthalpy of a species using the heat of formation method, we are taking the heat of formation at the reference state, 25 degrees Celsius, and adding any sensible heat change from our reference state of 25 degrees Celsius to our temperature that that species is at. Now, to account for this sensible heat difference, it's the heat capacity, which is a function of temperature, integrated between those two temperatures. So now we have our heat of formation and our sensible heat change, which we could calculate or look up in tables. So let's work through this table and start filling in some of these values. So let's start with ethane. Now we have ethane entering at 25 degrees Celsius and exiting at 300 degrees Celsius. So the enthalpy of ethane that is entering is just going to be the heat of formation of ethane at 25 degrees Celsius. Since we are not evaluating it at a different temperature, the sensible heat difference is zero. So we look this up in a table. So you can see that the heat of formation of ethane is negative 84.68 kilojoules per mole. So now this means in our table, we could plug in the specific enthalpy is negative 84.68. However, for the outlet, we need to evaluate this integral. So we look up the coefficients associated with the heat capacity as a function of temperature. Again, these could be looked up in the references I mentioned earlier. So to evaluate this integral, it's important to note whether it's in Celsius or Kelvin. So the values I looked up were for Kelvin. So we're evaluating from 298 Kelvin to 573 Kelvin. And so the heat capacity as a function of temperature has the following form. A plus BT plus CT squared plus DT cubed. And we evaluate that integral. So now we just have to look up the values for those coefficients. So now let me plug in these coefficients for ethane. Note that the coefficients are usually to some power, so to make sure to include that when you're doing your calculations. So if I evaluate this integral, we get the following sensible heat difference of roughly 19.27 kilojoules per mole. So that's this part of the equation. So it's not the specific enthalpy of the stream. We have to include the heat of formation at our reference state of 25 degrees Celsius. So when we take that negative 84.68 and add our sensible heat difference, we could get the enthalpy of ethane at 300 degrees Celsius. So I'll plug that into our table. Get negative 65.42. Now for all the other species, we could follow the exact same format. However, there are some certain shortcuts. I'm going to lump oxygen and nitrogen together so that you can see what we're going to do here. Now the table in the back of the Felder and Rousseau textbook lists these common combustion species at various temperatures using a reference of 25 degrees Celsius. This table, table B8 in the appendices, gives you the specific enthalpy of the selected gas using a reference of 25 degrees Celsius in one atmosphere. So what we could do is look up oxygen at 100 degrees for what's entering, and we see that it's 2.24 kilojoules per mole. Now this is this part of the equation. Since oxygen is already in its elemental state, and that was our references used for our method above, the heat of formation of oxygen is zero. So that part cancels out. And you can see that if we were at 25 degrees Celsius, we'd have an enthalpy of zero, which is our reference state. So this 2.24 is just our enthalpy associated with the temperature difference. So we look up the same for nitrogen, and now we have our enthalpies associated with those two species at 100 degrees Celsius. So for oxygen, we have 2.24. For nitrogen, we have 2.19. So as you can see, now we have everything we need for our inlet stream. We have to finish this for outlet. So we can do the exact same thing for oxygen and nitrogen at 300 degrees Celsius. Let's take a look at that table. Now at 300, we have 8.47 and 8.12. Now for water, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide, these aren't elemental species that are our reference states. So the heat of formation does need to be included in our calculation. So we could look those up in a table and add what we see in this other table to get our final specific enthalpy at those temperatures. Let me show you. So let's take water at 300 degrees Celsius. It has a specific enthalpy of 9.57 when using a reference temperature of 25. So again, this is this part of the equation, the sensible heat change. We add the heat of formation. So this looks like negative 241.84 plus 9.57, which gives us a specific enthalpy of water at 300 degrees Celsius of negative 232.27 kilojoules per mole. So now we could do this calculation for carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide and finish our enthalpy table above. So now we have our enthalpy table with our molar flow rates. All that's left to do is calculate our overall energy balance. Because recall, the problem asked how much energy is absorbed or generated from this reactor. So our overall energy balance is going to have the following form, where we have the heat absorbed or generated by the reaction is going to be equal to the enthalpy difference between the outlet and inlet streams. And what this means is that we could set this equal to the sum of each component times its specific enthalpy. This is going to be for the outlet, and we're going to subtract that same form for the inlet. So just to be clear, let's set this up for ethane. If we look at the outlet, we have 2.5 moles times the specific enthalpy associated with ethane in that stream. Now we're going to subtract out the flow in the inlet stream times the specific enthalpy associated with ethane in that stream. And now we continue this for each species. Now when you do this, you get this nice long drawn out equation with all your values plugged in, and I get a Q equal to negative 8,388, or roughly 8,400 kilojoules. So notice we do have a heat that is produced by the reaction. It is coming out of the reactor, which is something we would expect for the combustion of ethane. But again, this does depend on the inlet and outlet temperatures of our streams, so it's always good to double check those values. So after looking at a reaction like this, think about how we could produce more heat. In this problem, we used air, and we had to heat up our nitrogen, and it comes out at a higher temperature, so it absorbs some of the heat produced by the reaction. Now, if we use pure oxygen, we would not have this enthalpy lost to this nitrogen. So that's one way we might be able to get maybe even a more efficient combustion, as well as more energy produced by that combustion. Now, I hope this helps show you how to set up an energy balance table and the overall energy balance. After this, visit the Material and Energy Balances Final Review, Part 3.